Today we are back with another amazing movie. This movie is about a sex addict whose sister stays with him for a long period of time and now he has to manage everything. Shame investigates the nature of need, how we conduct our lives, and the events that shape our personalities. Hello and welcome to Binge King. Watch out for spoilers and take care. Without any further delay, let us start. Brandon is a prosperous, attractive 30-year-old businessman based in New York City. He is battling with sexual addiction, which is unknown to people who know him. He flirts with a young woman on a subway train and she flirts back. She is wearing a wedding and engagement ring and blends into the crowd as they disembark the train. Brandon and his boss David go out after work and meet three women at a club. Brandon later had sex with the lady David was pursuing. When Brandon returns home, he believes a burglar has broken into his home, but instead discovers a naked woman showering. It is his sister, Sissy, a troubled young lady who has been left as damaged as Brandon by their turbulent childhood, which is never fully revealed. Sissy reveals to Brandon that she has been living in Los Angeles for the past year and playing in small bars as a singer. Sissy claims she has no place to live after falling on hard times and asks if she may stay with him for a bit. Brandon grudgingly accepts the offer. Before we go ahead, subscribe, press the bell icon to get the latest updates about new movies. Now, let's get back to the movie. Brandon and David go to a club the next night to see Sissy perform a lovely, melancholy jazz version of New York, New York. Sissy then sits down at Brandon and David's table and tells them a little bit more about herself and her singing career. They all return to Brandon's flat after a friendly conversation over drinks. Sissy and David head up to Brandon's apartment while Brandon checks his mail in the lobby. Brandon enters the room and hears Sissy having sex with David in his bed via the bedroom door. Brandon exits his flat and runs across the streets, his earphones playing Bach's piano music. Brandon returns home to discover Sissy and David have vanished. He hurriedly changes his sheets and retires to his bed. Sissy climbs into the bed and wants to snuggle him later that night, which irritates him. Brandon yells at her to return to sleeping on the couch, and she ignores him. Brandon then tries to pursue a relationship with his co-worker Marianne at work, flirting with her and inviting her to dine with him, which she accepts. Brandon resists making a pass on Marianne after a casual and enjoyable supper at a nearby restaurant, despite the young awkward waiter interrupting them multiple times. At the conclusion of the meal, they part ways, and he returns home alone. Sissy arrives at Brandon's place later that night and inadvertently walks in on him masturbating in the toilet. She then discovers his laptop, which is open and full with pornography. While waiting for Brandon, a woman is half-dressed and stroking herself through the laptop webcam. He says he would like to see the two women get together. Brandon swoops in and accuses Sissy of spying on him, prompting her to flee. Brandon then purges his apartment of all of his pornography, including his laptop, and disregards everything. He approaches Marianne the next day at work and takes her to a luxurious hotel room. He snorts a line of cocaine in the bathroom, concealed from Marianne's eyes. They try to have sex, but Brandon is unable to keep an erection. Marianne departs, leaving him alone and humiliated in his hotel room. Brandon is then seen in the same hotel room having sex with another woman. Brandon comes home and watches cartoons on his television, where Sissy greets him. He inquires as to her whereabouts, and she replies that she was with David. Brandon informs Sissy that David is married, and Sissy responds that she already knew because David informed her on their first night together. Brandon informs Sissy angrily that she must go by the end of the week to hunt for her own apartment. She claims that they are family and they are expected to aid one another, but Brandon refuses to have anything to do with her, claiming that she only serves to drag him down. Brandon then goes out to a club and tries to pick up a woman, but is thrashed by her boyfriend after he insults him by telling him how he would please her. He tries to enter a nightclub bruised and beaten, but he is denied entry since the partygoers appear to be considerably younger than the club's normal population. In fact, they are most likely underage. Therefore, the bouncer maintains that he can go in that night. Brandon walks across the street to a homosexual pub and enters. A man approaches him and kisses him as he walks through it, then performs fellatio on him in one of the back rooms. Brandon is then seen entering a cheap hotel room with two women. He ended up having sex with both of them simultaneously. When he gets out of the house, he notices that Sissy has left a voicemail on his phone. He disembarks from the train since it has been delayed due to an alleged suicide farther up the lines. He phones Sissy in a panic, but she does not answer, so he rushes home. Sissy is laying on the bathroom floor after cutting her wrist when he arrives. He pays her a visit at the hospital when she survives. He collapses in tears in the rain as he walks away. Brandon is subsequently seen sitting on the train, heading to work as normal. The same woman from the start sits across from him, only her engagement ring on her finger. He attempts to look away, but she only stares and smiles at him, plainly flirting with him. She rises to exit the train, anticipating him to follow her like he did the previous time. Brandon remains staring at her and the screen goes black before viewers can figure out whether he will follow her or not. The name of this amazing movie is Shame. Shame is a 2011 British psychological drama film directed by Steve McQueen and set in New York. It stars Michael Fassbender and Carey Mulligan as grown siblings and was co-written by McQueen and Abby Morgan. Film 4 and Seesaw Films collaborated on the project. The film received an NC-17 certification in the United States due to the film's explicit sequences depicting the protagonist's sexual addiction. On January 13 of 2012, Shame was released in the United Kingdom. On the 2008 feature Hunger, McQueen collaborated with producer Ian Canning, and the two reconnected to develop Shame alongside Canning and Emile Sherman's UK-Australia-based Seesaw Films. Abby Morgan, a screenwriter, was chosen to write the script, one of the two projects she worked on with Film 4. That is all for today, folks. Tell us in the comment section what is your point of view about this amazing movie. See you soon with another amazing video.